Committee. It's a very important bill which can change how homeopathy is managed, both education across the country, sir. As you know, sir, homeopathy, the basic principle of the homeopathy is like cures like. So, apna India mein jaisa kanta ko nikalna hai to kanta istemal karna padta. That is the basic kanta se nikalna padta. So, that is the basic concept of this homeopathy, sir. Why this bill is brought in by the minister? At the outset, I must appreciate the minister of the Ayush for making the yoga, which is now make a world famous. Now we have got an international yoga day, and also the alternative medicine, that is Ayush, that's including all specialties, have got a respectability across the, not only countries, sir, across the world. I think I must appreciate him before I talk on the bill. Why this bill has been brought? While the minister was introducing the bill, he has said specifically, because of the rampant corruption, lack of transparency, and lack of adequate educational skills. These are the 3 points: educational qualifications, infrastructure across the various homeopathy medical colleges. This bill has been brought in to kill the old act, that is 1973, sir. That's fair enough. We don't absolutely refute the intentions of the minister. We hold, we'll agree, sir. But the question is, this problem is not only a part of the bill, sir, only homeopathy bill. This problem is across the India, so much so now we believe whether the corruption genes are mutated in every Indian, so that every institution is corrupt, now has become a corrupt, sir. Now, while introducing the bill, sir, the new situation, institution will be brought in where the central government, the Ministry of the Ayush, will have a direct supervision by nominating the Board of Governors from the people with the eminence in the education. And I would like to, sir, I would like to you to add, it is an integrity in the homeopathy medicine, sir. That is the word he is using in the bill. I feel that it's not the what is required, integrity in the homeopathy, sir. It is integrity of the person is required, because the whole board was accused of the corruption, corruptive practices. It is not the integrity of the in the homeopathy, it is the integrity of the persons who are going to be the tomorrow board of governors that need to be taken. Otherwise, like a homeopathy, like use, like, and we will have again this problem. It is the persons is the problem, it's the act is not the problem, sir. And I do agree, in our country, power corrupts. Absolute power corrupts absolutely. That is way in every institutions. And to be frank, sir, my 4 years experience in the parliament, if at all, parliament, in terms of the corruption index, I can say wholeheartedly, politicians, they have to undergo test every 5 years, and they are being questioned by the media and the parliament, and they are persons who are rightly, they should be, every act should be answerable to the parliament. I think earlier, these institutions are law upon to themselves. They are not going to listen to anybody, and that is, I welcome, sir. And regarding the various other things, the most important section, sir. Now, there is a section is introduced in the section 12. Just 1 second. Section 12B, sir, 12C. What is the section 12C says? All the homeopathy medical colleges which have been accorded permission already have to again seek the permission, sir, within 1 year. My earlier colleague has raised the same problem. Suppose if you put that class, there are two chances. If the people who are putting a new governors are not having a adequate integrity, that will open the floodgates of the corruption. Second, what happens to the students who have studied 2 years? Suddenly you do recognize, where do they go? We have not made any provision for that. Because when we are making a law, we are playing with the lives of the many students. At least by framing the rules, I request the minister, if at all such situation arises, there should be a remedy also for that, sir. And regarding the homeopathy, sir, homeopathy, may not be effective for all the diseases, but definitely for a chronic illness, it is effective to some extent. And today, sir, you open any TV, any newspaper, you got hundreds of the advertisements regarding the homeopathy, but constitutional homeopathy, parliament homeopathy, Rajya Sabha homeopathy, like that every homeopathy full of page advertisements. It is again, there is no system to monitor it. There is no system what they are delivering it. And as per the medical ethics, you cannot advertise beyond a limit. You should open any channel, sir, Hindi, Telugu, Tamil, English. You see, sir, whether you are going to willing to take some action to curb these unethical practices, which will have a huge bearing on the homeopathy system at all, sir. And second thing, last before I conclude, sir, as I said, there is a National Institute of Homeopathy of excellent eminences. Now, we know many people, including, I think, many of our other members also take homeopathy for certain illnesses, chronic illnesses, sir. But we have got only one National Institute of Homeopathy at the Calcutta, sir. I take this opportunity to urge upon the minister to open one more National Institute of Homeopathy in my youngest state of the Telangana state. I hope you will...
Srimati PK.
I hope...
Srimati teacher. Right.